Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zolotech, and iOS 16.2 Developer Beta 1 is now out to developers and soon to public beta testers. And this is a pretty large install. Since yesterday, we just had iOS 16.1 released to the public. Now we have 16.2 betas, which is pretty normal, and this is going to be a very large install since you're going from a normal version back to a beta. And you'll see it was 5.32 gigabytes, that's on my iPhone 14 Pro Max, and it was just under 5 gigabytes on the other devices we have here. Along with this, Apple also released watchOS 9.2 Beta 1, iPadOS 16.2 Beta 1, macOS 13.1 Beta 1, as well as tvOS 16.1 Beta 1, and HomePodOS 16.2 Beta 1. All of those are available now. Now let's go ahead and take a look at the build number and talk about what's new. So we'll go to Settings, then we'll go to General, then About, and if we tap on the version number, you can see the build number is 20C5032E. And this particular update does have some new features and changes in it, and the first thing is a modem update. We do have a modem update coming from 16.1 to the new 16.2 betas. So again, if you're having connectivity issues, there's some refinements to this. Hopefully it improves over the next few days. Also, one thing to note before we talk about new features is this does not bring 5G to phones in India yet. Apple has said that's coming in December. It's not in these betas. Maybe in later betas it will be available though. Now, as far as what's new, the first small change is in Settings and Software Update. The actual text here continues to be adjusted. Apple keeps changing this. So you'll see the font is a little bit more pronounced. It's bold. And the font underneath it says iOS is up to date. It's smaller. A very small change, but something that's new. Also, on all the Face ID devices, I had the hello screen when I rebooted. So that's something I saw but didn't see on the Touch ID phone. The first major change or update, though, is the Freeform app. This is something Apple talked about when they initially announced iOS 16, and Freeform allows for collaboration across many different people and devices. So maybe you want to work on a project together. You can share a Freeform board across many devices and then collaborate in real time across those devices. Now, it does seem to be a bit buggy as I've been trying this out a little bit. If I go to share, let's see if it works here. And I get an error. So even though this is syncing to iCloud, which is turned off by default, I'll show you that in a moment, it does give me an error. So it says document has not synced yet, please wait before attempting to share. So there's still some issues with this, but it allows for collaboration with many different tools. And let me show you that on the iPad as it's a little bit larger. Now on the iPad, it comes pre-installed with Freeform. The app is there. You can delete it. If you press and hold remove, you have the option to delete the app if you want to. However, it's pre-installed on all of these devices. And the first time you open it, you get a splash screen like you do on many new apps that says get creative, build your board, collaborate with others. So that's something that popped up the first time I opened it. And as you can see, here's Freeform. Now I do have dark mode on. So if we pull down the control center, you'll see dark mode's on. And if we go into a board, it just says the word hello. It says resume to 100%. And then of course we can share this and then collaborate in real time. So we could share this with someone else via messages or directly, and then they can collaborate in real time. Of course we have our options for our pen tool, just like notes. And of course we have a little post-it note we could put here. We also have some shapes we can add. So if you want to add an arrow, we can add that in here, resize it, whatever you want to do. And then also we can add photos. So it's just a collaboration board for ideas where people can collaborate in real time across multiple devices at once. So as I draw here, it should show on others. I wasn't able to get this to sync though on the iPhone. I thought maybe I could have it sync in real time across the different devices. Let's see where it went here. And it doesn't really seem to work. So right now I have it actually turned on so that I can use it across devices. Now it's actually working. So let's see if we can get this to work in real time. It wasn't working earlier, so just be aware that it could be a bit buggy. So as I draw here, let's see if it updates in real time down here, and it did. So it's actually updating in real time. And if I draw maybe on the iPhone, we'll just draw a line here. Let's see if it shows up on the iPad. But I did have some syncing issues initially, and I had to turn the syncing on in order for this to work. So you'll see it's not sort of syncing in real time back from the iPhone, but it worked from the iPad to the iPhone. So as I scribble there, to zoom out, it does take a moment to update. So for whatever reason, it seems to be a little slow that way. And like I said, there's an option for this as far as collaboration and syncing it with iCloud. So if we go into our settings, put the pencil down, and then we go into our name at the top and then tap on iCloud. You can see here, if we tap on Show All, scroll down, and you'll see that there's the option for Freeform. It was turned off by default. I had to turn this on, and then things started to sync properly. So if you want to try this out, just keep in mind you may need to enable that within your iCloud settings. Now, also on the iPad, if we go into the TV app, they've now moved the account to the bottom left. So on the iPad, it's in the bottom left. They haven't changed it on the iPhone, though. And with iOS 16.1, they introduced Live Activities. And they've brought back the Live Activities toggle within the TV app, like we had before. They removed it with iOS 16.1, but now it's back with 16.2. If we go into it, there's nothing there yet, but eventually we'll have Live Activities for sports and more, and then be able to use those on our lock screen. So as soon as they enable that for sports within TV, we should see that. Now also on the iPad, they've added external display support again. So when you plug it in, we now have our external display support options. So if we go into settings, you'll see we don't have anything there now. Under display and brightness, there's nothing there. Let me go ahead and plug in a display. So if I plug in my Pro Display XDR, give it a moment to connect. We'll wait for it just a moment here. There it goes. And now we have Pro Display XDR. And under arrangement, we can either mirror the display or just use it as an external display. This worked in earlier betas of iOS 16, and they removed it with 16.1. Now it's back with 16.2. So again, we have options for brightness. Maybe you can see it get lighter and darker back here. And then also display zoom for more space, default, larger text. And then also high dynamic range, standard dynamic range, and allow display mode changes. So all of those have been brought back with iPadOS 16.2. Of course, you'll need a supporting iPad, basically an M1 or M2 iPad, to use external displays, though. With iOS 16.1, Apple added Matter support. Within the Home app, Matter is now supported, but there will be a Home app architecture update, and you can see that here by tapping on your options, going to Home Settings. Under Home Settings, you can see as we scroll down under Software Update, you'll see Home Upgrade Available. It says, Home now has a new underlying architecture that will improve the performance of your homes. If you tap on this, you'll need all of your HomePods updated to HomePodOS 16.2 in order for that to work. So once your software is up to date, you can upgrade this home. So that's something they've updated with 16.2 that I'll have to try out once the HomePods have been updated. Also, when you go into the News app, there's a new splash screen. It says, Welcome to Apple News, and then it says, Siri suggests stories, channels, and topics based on Safari and app usage. And then you can tap Continue and go into your news. So that's a splash screen that just shows up. I didn't see any in other apps, though. Now, something that people are seeing more and more, not just on iOS 16.2, but 16.1 as well, is Apple is now serving more ads in the App Store. If we scroll down, you'll see one here, and as we continue to scroll, we may see more and more of them. So there should be more and more ads showing up. Unfortunately, there's no way to really disable that. They're just adding that and have said that they're going to be adding that. So you may see that throughout the iOS App Store app. So maybe there and iPad as well. Now, as far as other features, we're still waiting for satellite connectivity. Still, we don't have anything as far as that goes. So nothing in our cellular settings or our emergency SOS settings. That should be coming later to iPhone 14. Maybe with beta 2, we'll see that. And also the Apple Wallet savings account that I mentioned with iOS 16.1 after I released that video, Apple actually announced that they delayed that feature. So that's something coming a little bit later where you'll be able to use your Apple Wallet with a savings account and earn interest. So that's something coming later on. Also, they updated iWork apps today. So if you use Pages, Numbers, or Keynote, those have had a major update. So if we go to my account, you can see here they updated it today. Here's Keynote, but there's a lot of different updates for Pages, Keynote, and Numbers to version 12.2. So a lot of different new features and updates specifically for those apps on iPhone, iPad, and Mac as well. Now, one thing we're waiting for are AirPods updates. With AirPods, many of us are waiting for AirPods Pro 2 and other AirPods to be updated to help with connectivity. Many of us have been waiting for that. There's some additional bugs people have had with the AirPods, so we hopefully will see an update for those very soon. But so far, we haven't seen anything. Hopefully, we see them either today, tomorrow, or maybe in a few days or weeks, but hopefully sooner rather than later. Also, many of you have been asking me, when will we get new emoji? Well, it doesn't look until probably next year at this point. Last year, iOS 15.4 is when we had a bunch of new emoji, so probably a few versions out. Something that they don't really update unless the Unicode Consortium actually updates their standard. There's someone that makes the standard of emoji, and then iOS, Android, and others follow. Now, as far as the release notes, let's go into those. So we'll go over to our feedback app, and within our iOS and iPadOS 16.2 beta release notes, there's a couple issues with Freeform, one I actually experienced where it can't delete boards while offline or if iCloud data is disabled for Freeform. I had to actually enable that, and I showed you that earlier. Also, adding or removing collaborators can fail. They give a workaround for that. There's also known issues with external displays in Stage Manager. And then also Swift UI, they've resolved an issue as far as animated layout changes now support up to 120Hz ProMotion displays. And again, there's a TV app known issue as well for play tracking. So some known issues with this, not a ton of them. So it looks like they're moving along nicely. Of course, they should have more and more bug fixes. The screen flickering issue that many people had when the display brightness was low, many people have told me has been fixed with iOS 16.1. I'm curious to know if you had this on your iPhone 14, if that's been resolved, but I haven't really heard of any other issues with this update. As far as performance, ProMotion does seem to be nice and smooth. Overall performance is good, and opening games and opening apps seem to be okay with it. So if we go into music for the first time on the 8 Plus, you'll see it's refreshing, as I would expect. We'll give it just a moment here, and there we go. So no issues there. Seems to be fairly smooth, not as smooth as ProMotion, of course. However, there are some reports online of stutter in games such as Genshin. So some people are having stutter. Let's go into Minecraft as I had it loaded. Let's just see how quickly it reloads. Give it a moment here. And now we're in. So that's pretty quick. As we move around, I'm not seeing any stuttering here. There I did. I just saw it just as I was saying that. So again, there could be some stutter here and there, but it is an early beta. And if you're having issues, make sure you report it in feedback. Good news, though, is I'm not hearing much about the phone getting very hot. It actually has been quite cool even when installing the update, and I don't worry too much about that as iOS manages that, but many people are saying it stays nice and cool, so that's a good sign. Also, YouTube got a major update. You may or may not be seeing that with redesigned buttons, and also eventually the subscribe button and more will be changed. So that's going to be changed in many different versions of YouTube that you'll see. It's no longer going to be red. It's going to be a white subscribe button, and they're changing the overall scrubbing ability so you can really finely tune where you want to see in the app and much more. Thumbnails will be rounded on the corners and much more. So if you have that update, I'd love to hear from you in the comments below. Now, if you're wondering if you should install iOS 16.2 Beta 1, well, if you had issues and you just want to be on a stable release, definitely stay on iOS 16.1 for now. If you want to try it out, of course you can, but there aren't any major features other than Freeform that you may want to try out just yet. That will be coming very soon, probably in the next month or month and a half or so. So at this point, if you want to try out Freeform, you can. Just make sure you have a backup and you know what you're getting into if you need to downgrade using a computer. But again, just make sure you have that backup. As far as battery life, well, this takes a few days to measure for sure. We don't really know what battery life is like right away, but so far, hopefully it's the same or better than 16.1. Battery health on this device is 100% as it's new. And if we go over the last 10 days, yesterday, I had 4.5 hours of screen on time, or 4 hours and 29 minutes, 6 hours and 54 minutes of screen off time. Used about 60% of my battery, so 60-65%. It's getting better for me, and the day before, about the same if you have that. So I'm only getting about 8 hours of screen on time. I would expect it to improve. I continue to change my settings for the home and lock screen to help improve that. Typically with this beta, just like other betas, I would expect iOS 16.2 beta 2 to be a couple weeks away. Usually the first 2 or 3 betas will have a beta every other week. So maybe the 8th of November, and we probably won't see any sort of release with this until maybe December. It could be late November, but maybe December with that 5G update for phones in India as far as 5G is concerned, and those other updates I talked about earlier. So look for that, and then maybe in between we'll have an iOS 16.1.1 or something like that if they need to fix any issues. As far as benchmarks, I did run those quickly just to take a look, and you'll see here single core was 1,876, multi-core was 5,311. Compared to before, let's take a look here, you'll see it's very similar. within 2 points for single core, and it's a little bit faster for multi-core. So usually within 100 or so, or a couple hundred, it's fine. You shouldn't really notice any difference. Now, if you found anything else in iOS 16.2 beta 1, I'd love to hear from you in the comments below. And of course, we should have new iPad Pro and iPad releases tomorrow as well. So I'll be sure to check those out as soon as I can. If you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.